Hey guys, I'm going to run you through the Convolverb plugin in N-Track. It can create enormous possibilities in your music making and is super fun to play with. So I'm starting by loading Virtual Instrument, Elegance Piano Soft. It's a favourite of mine, sounds like this. And in the higher register, just to give you an idea of the starting sound. Without further ado, we're going to jump into Convolverb, which can be accessed like this. Here's how Convolverb looks. So there are a variety of reverb plugins of varying size, length, and timbre. We're going to start with Echo Hall. There's the original source piano sound. And here it is with the reverb, which adds that layer of sheen, shine, and warmth. Here it is in the higher range. Okay, so that's some nice reverb that we've added to the piano. Let's get cinematic now. This one's called Hanger, much larger. Here's the piano without the reverb. And with. So there's that Hollywood trailer piano sound out of the box, which completely transforms the original sound. It really works well in that low register. And there it is without, just to demonstrate the difference. And if you couldn't tell already, that's one of my favorite presets. I also wanted to demo another preset. It's called Doubler. It's smaller in size and doubles the input signal. It sounds like this. So it can be useful to create those pop piano riffs in this style. But now is where things get really interesting, the orange squiggly line. I'm going to open up Victoria Dome, which is a dark, long-ish reverb, and click on the squiggly line. So now we can play with the impulse response of the reverb in terms of length. We can reverse it. We can affect the pre-delay, make it drier or wetter. So I'm going to start by reversing this response. And you can hear that the sound completely inverts and it creates a new effect. You can adjust the length so that the reverb impulse becomes more pronounced. And you can also amplify the waveform and decrease it. Another nifty feature in Convolverb is that you can customize the envelope filter to your liking by clicking and dragging, as is shown here. I've reversed the impulse response and adjusted the dry and wet knobs to my liking. It sounds like this. So as you can see, there's lots of things to play with here. Now we're going to go deeper. Select any preset, click the File button, and locate a music file.
Let it, let it, let it go.
Here's a vocal example. It's a WAV, and we can load this as its own impulse response. So we've got the power to create our own way to shape sounds. Here's the original piano. You can hear that vocal almost pulse coming in as a reverb. Here it is reversed. It's starting to get really warped here. I'm going to make it a little wetter. Play with the dry knob. Cut the length so it's a little bit more punchy. And yeah, I definitely prefer the sound when it's not reversed. Add some chords, and we're starting to make a track. And it's got that custom kind of wonky vibe, which whether it's a keyboard, a vocal, a violin, a guitar, is going to create an infinite possibilities in terms of sound worlds. Speaking of which, we're going to move away from the piano for a minute and change the input signal to a vocal. So we're going to add everyone's favourite Christmas song, the first Noel. Or an excerpt from that. We're going to drag that into the session. And we're going to open up Convolverb again. So go into the effects chain, go down to end track, select Convolverb. So you can hear that the vocal is more pronounced with the reverb from the stock plate preset. Let's move on to On a Star. That larger size gives a really dark vibe to the vocal. So let's develop the sound some more and reverse the impulse response. And you can really hear what that's doing. Okay, let's stick with the vocal and choose another preset. We're going to go over to Victoria Dome, select the orange squiggly line, reverse that, but shorten the length of the impulse response so it's more prominent. And in this way, I'm sure you can see that you can create a ton of effects to use within your music productions. Let's also walk through adding our own custom impulse response to that same vocal. Remember this one?
Let it, let it.
We're going to add that in, so vocal to vocal impulse response. Let's just shorten that in length. Let's hear how it sounds reversed. Completely twisted. Good news is that Convolverb is available on the N-Track app on both iOS and Android, as well as the desktop version of N-Track. It's worth pointing out that Convolverb can be a little more heavy on CPU. On a modern PC or Mac, you won't notice the difference, but if you're chaining reverbs or using Convolverb on multiple tracks on an older computer, you may notice a lag in performance, just as an FYI. Personally, I'm using Convolverb for a bunch of my productions, particularly the custom import for the impulse responses. If you've got any more questions, just drop them in the comments below and I'll try and answer them. I hope this video has inspired you to find some new sound worlds for your productions. All the best with your music making, and we'll speak again soon.